morning, Chargers.
I'm Trinity Marks.
I'm Camille Sennett.
I'm Savannah Bone.
Hi, I'm Jasmine.
I'm Amelia Mack.
I'm Alyssa Grazius.
I'm Danny Aisel.
My name is Nick Rossell.
Hi, I'm Sierra Johnson.
I'm Jordan.
Hi, I'm Rena Rupp.
I'm Trinity Sipple.
I'm Taina Black.
I'm Abby Forsyth.
I'm Morgan Barry.
John Antonio.
I'm Lyle.
I'm Chandler Morrell.
And I'm Nick Butler.
And this is the morning show on CTN.
Good morning, Chargers. I'm Karina Silva, and this is the morning show on CTN. I'm Morgan Barrett. Today is Friday, April 22nd, 2016. Today is Earth Day.
Today, students are wearing blue shirts as part of their Light It Up blue campaign for autism awareness. There are a lot of kids out there who don't know what autism is. So here is a short video to tell you more about it.
Why does Jamie not understand things usually?
When I was younger, I always thought maybe being different, maybe it's bad or it's not good or it will threaten other people or I don't know, some crazy stuff.
People react strangely to it sometimes, like wow, they're different to us. They can't be our friends.
It sort of seems like you're in your own world. And if I was to try and pick out someone in the schoolyard, the kid would probably be alone.
I just saw my mum crying on the lounge at home and then with my dad, and they were talking about it. And I pretty much just asked, you know, what's going on? And she told me that he had autism. I didn't really understand it at the time, but it's probably a big deal, yeah.
These kids are the brothers, the sisters, and the friends of kids with autism. And they're going to help explain what autism is, how it affects the kids who have it, and how autistic kids connect with the world around them. Currently in Australia, one in 110 children are diagnosed with autism.
No, it's not contagious. No, not at all. It's not like a disease or anything.
It's not like a virus or a bacteria. It's just a condition of the mind, and people aren't going to have things jumping out of your mind for your skull.
The technical name for autism is autism spectrum disorder, or ASD. And spectrum here means that the symptoms of autism can range from very severe to very mild and all places in between.
You can tell if someone has autism if they, made weird groaning sounds.
Not making very much sense, flapping your arms about.
Imagine the kids in a school playground are sailing ships. Their big sails are kind of like big personalities, all different colours and easy to see. Now, imagine ASD kids are icebergs, floating around in the same ocean, doing their own thing as well. But you don't get to see all of their bright colours. You only see the tip of the iceberg. That's because 90% of an iceberg is underwater, where you can't see it. Invisible. It's only when you get close and dive in do you get to see all the shapes and wonder that are hidden below the surface.
I believe if you sort of get under their shell, they're just perfectly normal, perfectly nice. They're just beautiful people.
They're smart kids whose brains tend to scramble information on the way in. Kids with autism face challenges in every aspect of their lives. And the best way they can prepare for these challenges is to have great friends. And just because a kid with autism is different, it doesn't mean they won't turn out to be the best friend you've ever had, ever.
This year, Sesame Street introduced its first autistic character, whose name is Julia, to help kids at a young age understand autism better.
Swing, 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 swing. Hi, Elmo. Oh, who's your friend?
Oh, hi, Abby. This is Julia. Julia, this is Abby.
Hi, Julia. It's nice to meet you. Julia, can I play with you? Elmo, your friend
Abby. No, Abby. Elmo doesn't think that's true. Julia sometimes does things differently because Julia has autism. Right, Julia? Elmo thinks Abby can ask Julia to play again. Abby could use fewer words and wait a little bit. That usually works for Elmo.
Oh, got it. Can I play?
Play with Abby and Elmo. Play Spy.
Oh, I love the game I Spy.
Elmo does too. Let's play. Elmo spies with Elmo's little eye a tiny red feather.
Oh, I know where to look. Out here. Woohoo! Or over there.
Red, 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 red.
Julia found the red feather so fast.
Wow, Julia, you're amazing.
Julia, you always win at I Spy.
Play Spy, come.
Yeah.
On my way. I'm flapping as fast as I can. Woohoo!
Very often you will see people with a puzzle piece symbol used to show autism awareness. The puzzle pattern reflects the complexity of the autism spectrum. The different colors and shapes represent the diversity of the people and families living with the condition.
As you can see, kids with autism are different, but special in their own way, just like the rest of us. Be aware that there are a lot of kids who have autism, but that they need friends and love, friends, love, and support, just like the rest of us.
Now here's Cammie with today's weather forecast. Good morning, Cammie.
Hi, Karina. It's going to be a warm day today with a high of 78. We will see some sun off and on throughout the day, and then there is some rain moving into the area around 6 p.m. tonight. We may see thunderstorms for a few hours, but it will be dry again by 8 or 9 tonight. Tomorrow will start off cloudy, but the sun will come out in the afternoon with a high of 71, and on Sunday it will be sunny and 69 degrees. Enjoy the weekend. Back to you at the news desk.
Thanks, Cammie. There are no local celebrity birthdays today, but on Saturday, Jaden Dickerson in 7th grade celebrates his birthday, and on Sunday, Rachel Antonio in grade 3 celebrates her birthday. Jaden and Rachel, from all of us at CTN, we hope you have a wonderful birthday.
In music news, music legend Prince passed away suddenly yesterday at the age of 57. Prince, whose real name is Prince Rogers Nelson, was from Minnesota. He had many number one hits and also starred in the movie Purple Rain. Yesterday, after his death, places like Niagara Falls and Target Field in Minnesota lit up purple in memory of the legendary singer.
In the 1900s, he changed his name. 1990s, he changed his name to this symbol during a dispute with his record label and became known as the artist formerly known as Prince. And in 2000, when his contract expired, he changed his name back to Prince. It was the 1984 that Purple Rain, his first number one album on the Billboard 200, that earned him his place in history as one of the greatest artists of his generation.
The album earned him 2 Grammys, an Oscar, and a victory over Michael Jackson's Thriller for Favorite Pop Rock Album at the 1985 American Music Awards. In total, he would receive 7 Grammy Awards from 32 nominations between 1984 and 2010.
He also wrote the music for Tim Burton's 1989 Batman film.
In Minneapolis, crowds raged in age from their 20s and to their 80s. They sang, embraced, and talked about how Prince showed the music industry you don't need to be from the East or West Coast to make it big. Asher Wade, age 27, spent the day listening to Prince music with friends and came to the First Avenue with a purple teardrop painted on his face. I grew up listening to his music, he said. My parents loved him. I grew to love him. It's heartbreaking. He will forever be a music legend.
Lastly, today is Earth Day. Here's Jordan to tell us more.
Earth Day was started by Senator Gaylord Nelson as a day of education about environmental issues on April 22, 1970, and is now a globally celebrated holiday that is sometimes extended into Earth Week, a full 7 days of events focused on green awareness. Earth Day was originally aimed at creating a mass environmental movement. Each year, people plant trees, recycle, and do things to take better care of the planet. The thing is, we should be taking care of the planet every day, not just on Earth Day. Here are some kids to tell you why it's important to save the planet.
Earth Day is a day where people can celebrate how beautiful Earth is and how important it is.
Earth Day is like a day where like people like celebrate the plants and like, you know, like the trees and everything like that.
Crazy.
No, I did not know that. That makes me feel like really mad.
That's crazy because there's a lot of fish in the ocean.
Well, that makes me feel that like maybe we should be using less plastic.
That's like shocking. You're putting more garbage than like trying to help living things. It's ridiculous.
Like it's as if somebody was putting all of their trash into like your house. And that's how like it would feel for like a fish.
The fact that if I threw this away that it could end up like into the ocean and hurting the environment is really shocking.
I feel like that could be used for so much different stuff, like besides just wasting it. I mean, not just toys, but everything else that involves plastic, because a lot of things involve plastic.
It's important to recycle because there's a lot of stuff and you don't want to just like throw it out immediately. It's bad for the environment and you could be reusing it.
So if you learn about ways you can take better care of the earth today, make a decision to try to do them every day. The 8th graders will be weeding and planting flowers in front of Crowley Hall today. 2nd grade is making dirt cups. 5th grade will be learning about Earth Day and the effects of global warming on animals in cold climates. And 4th grade will be reading The Lorax by Dr. Seuss, which is often used to teach kids the importance of taking care of our Earth. Mrs. Smith's son, AJ, is already learning about The Lorax. Let's take a look at these adorable pictures. I'm not sure if you could see it or not, but on the blanket he is on, it says, "Save the Earth for me." This is one of those situations where we can't keep saying, someone should do something about this. People have been saying that for years. Wake up, Chargers. We are the someone who have to do something and save the Earth now, for ourselves and for the kids like AJ. What are you going to do to help save the planet? Happy Earth Day.
Thanks, Jordan. That does it for the morning show today. We hope you learned a lot on today's broadcast. For Karina, Cami, Jordan, and all of us here at CTN, we hope you have a great Charger Friday and a glorious weekend. Bye!